I am here in Guatemala with my dear friend Scarlett. Scarlett Holcomb is, I don't know, what's your title with the medical mission teams? You're the president?
Yes.
What's your husband?
And he's the vice president. I am also the treasurer, and he's the secretary.
Okay. So you're like the chief executive officer, and he's like the chief operational officer?
That would be correct.
All right. It's my privilege to be on the second mission trip I've been on with Scarlett and her medical mission teams out of Atlanta. I went a couple of years ago to Madagascar, and now I'm in Guatemala. And just so you guys know, Scarlett loves being on video. She loves this. This is like her favorite. Ma'am, how long have you been running medical mission trips?
Going or running?
Well, how long have you been going on them, and then how long have you and your husband been running them?
I actually went on my first mission trip in 1996.
Okay.
And we actually started medical mission teams in 2010.
Okay. And you are a pharmacist, and your husband is an emergency room physician. And how many mission trips do you feel you've run and organized?
I stopped counting after I got to 100.
Okay, so triple digits.
Yeah, triple digits.
So you kind of go all over the world, and you go and you bring medical people who, or even non-medical people that want to be a part of just helping, serving others.
That is correct. We take anybody who has a heart that wants to serve.
Okay. What are the characteristics that make a great person on a mission team? Like, what makes a really great person on a mission team? What makes someone who maybe struggles a little bit?
Like I said, great person, someone who has a heart to serve. That's the biggest thing, and willingness to learn and maybe get outside of their comfort zone,
okay,
which is what I'm doing now with this video.
Yes, good.
Somebody who's not a good candidate would be somebody who has to have everything the way they have it at home, because they will be getting out of their comfort zone.
That's something that I realized in Madagascar. It's like a third world country where we had so limited resources, all we could do was the best we could do. And structure, it almost seems like you have to be flexible.
Yep, it is. And I will tell you that actually Madagascar is a fourth world country.
It's a fourth world country. So wait, I don't even know what a fourth world country means.
There are actually two fourth world countries designated by the World Health Organization.
Yes.
Madagascar and Burma or Myanmar. And it basically takes the life expectancy, health, daily income, and actually classifies it. So America is a first world.
Yes.
Then second world, actually Africa and Kenya is considered a third world.
Yes.
But if you actually go to Nairobi, Nairobi is considered second world for the city itself because of its structure.
Okay.
Guatemala is a third world, and Madagascar and Myanmar are both fourth world.
And when I asked you this trip, which country you like to go on mission trips the most, you said it was Madagascar. Why is that?
Because I feel like we can do the most good there and the most help.
I felt the same way. I loved going to Madagascar. If you have never been on a medical mission, my experience is it was joyous. It was, to me, it was peaceful, and I felt happy when I was there, when I'm here, and together that's joyous. And I highly recommend, especially if you lost a little bit of a spark for your medicine and you're kind of questioning, I can't believe I have to go to work. I found it very enjoyable. Do you have any advice on anybody who would be considering going on a medical mission trip?
Yeah, email me, call me.
Okay.
I'll be more than happy to talk to you. We actually have 10 trips set up from August of this year to March of 2020. Kenya, Madagascar, Guatemala, there is a need for all of the places, and I'd be more than happy to let people know if they're interested. And we will have definitely myself and my husband go on every trip. And I am a preceptor for Mercer for the pharmacy school, so we have pharmacy students.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And understand something, ladies and gentlemen, that there's a bunch of ways you can help. I mean, being present is fantastic, whether you have medical knowledge or not. Being present's one way. Another way is you could always donate. You could always donate, whether it is money. You could donate to buy supplies. And one of the things that I'm so proud of Scarlett and her husband, they're very good stewards of the resources. They're very dedicated to saving money where they can, on hotels and meals. So they're and they don't take money from people who join the trips to cover their own way. They work. You know, her husband works to pay their way so they could come here, which I think is very honorable. And so three ways you can help. You could join a mission trip, you could donate money, or if you have supplies. And this is really important. Maybe you work somewhere that you have outdated supplies or supplies you don't need. Well, guess what? They need them in Madagascar. They need them here in Guatemala. So keep that in mind too. Cool. Good luck and God bless.
Thank you.